I'll get to that in a second. Let's go back. $32 in the account. How do we make magic happen with $32? Like, what do we get with $32 that we can make multiply? I mean, I know you're a woman of faith, so you know you like the woman with the jars and the oil, and just oil just kept on pouring. Like, what did you get with the 32 jars, Gwen? $32.
So that's a fantastic question. And I'm so glad that you asked it, because I will also be like, well, how did you make $32 work? So here's the thing. Because I only had $32, I had to get real creative. And Damon John has a book. I cannot think of the name of it. Maybe you can. But it's basically about starting a business with nothing. And how The Power of Broke is the name of the book. And because you're broke, you actually have the power to utilize your creativity to make things happen, right? Whereas, like, when you just have money to throw at something, you can just throw money at something. It doesn't really matter how creative you are. But the people who are the most creative are actually the ones who tend to kind of make leaps and bounds over other folks, at least in the beginning, right? And if you haven't read The Power of Broke, mm-hmm. you definitely need to get it. It's a great book, whether or not you like Damon John. So with the $32, I had to find ways to make that work. So here in Detroit, we have this open air market called Eastern Market. And Eastern Market is it's not a flea market at all, but it's definitely an open air market. People sell produce, farmers come there, sell their produce. People also sell like lotions and candles and other things that they make, right? But you have to pay for a table at Eastern Market. Eastern Market probably has a few hundred vendors every single weekend, especially in the summertime. So you have to pay for a table and you have to pay for a space. I only had $32, and the table and space were like probably over $100. So I didn't have that. So what I did is I had a table in my garage and I had a tablecloth. So my son at the time was 2. He was still in his little carrier and he was real cute, you know. And so he had a handful of hair and I sell hair products, right? So I went to my garage and I got my table and I drove myself to Eastern Market and I set up shop and pretended like I was supposed to be there and was praying that the organizer did not come and see me and be like, who are you? What are you doing here? I figured like, okay, it's 200 or 300 people here. The chances of them like noticing little old me is probably kind of small, right? So let me just like hop over here on the end of somebody else's table with my table and just try to discreetly make something happen. And that's exactly what I did. So I am a person who believes in asking for forgiveness and not permission. So I was like, well, if they say you ain't supposed to be here, then I'll just be like, oh, my bad. I didn't know. Knowing I full well knew, right? So my son was in his carrier and I would take him with me and I would sit him up on the table in his carrier and I would have my products. And people love babies, especially cute babies with a lot of hair, right? So
they do.
He would attract people to the table. And they'd be like, oh my gosh, he's so cute. Blah, 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 right? He was saying a couple like little words here and there. So they were like, oh my gosh, he's so smart and you know, everything. And they'd be like, he has so much hair. And I would utilize that as my segue into talking about my hair products. And I would say, yeah, well, actually I use these products on him and that's why he has so much hair. And you know, then I would talk about the products and then they would buy it. And I would use that. So think about it, I had $32. It cost me gas money to get down there, right? So after that is gone. So let's say we spent $25. So now I've got like 7, right? But then I would sell my products at Eastern Market. And I would sell out every single weekend. And I would use the money that I made at Eastern Market to then pay my bills at my house, pay my mortgage, I didn't have a car note. Pay my mortgage, pay my, you know, utilities. And then the rest of the money I would use to buy more raw materials and more packaging to then go back the next weekend and sell more. And so that's how I made it work in the beginning.